when you go to China or you go to Japan or Korea, as an American, you know that people don't speak the same language. So you're likely to have a translator, you're likely to have a cultural interpreter with you, and they help kind of guide your way. But as an American, whether you are at a medtech company or you are a citizen, chances are that your physician might be Indian American. 1/3 of the doctors in this country are from India. You know, chances are that there are people in your company who are from India, and they seem to speak reasonably good English. And so you say, if I can understand Dr. Gupta, or I can understand, you know, Jay Patel who works with me, certainly I can understand the Indian customer and the Indian distributor when I go there. And of course, they speak English. Okay, yes, they speak English, but they don't think American. Okay, and that's the key difference that keeps me in business. Okay, just because you understand the words doesn't mean you understand the paragraphs or you understand the sense behind the words. And this is a topic I give workshops on doing business in India. I spend half a day talking about this. Today we have only one slide on the subject. Okay. So first of all is the vast differences in accents. Okay. Second of all are the differences in terminology. Indians will use words that sound like English but don't occur in American. So an Indian may ask you to prepone a meeting and you say, what in the world is that? Okay. It's the opposite of postpone. Okay. They invented that word. They don't call an appendix at the end of a document. They call it an annexure. You might not find that word in the dictionary, but it's an English word in India. Okay. Did anybody here watch The Million Dollar Arm, the Walt Disney movie from some years ago, Million Dollar Arm? Okay. That describes a baseball recruiter going to India and encountering a lot of interesting challenges. So an Indian will say yes in many different ways that seem like no to us. You know, this is a yes in India. Okay, this is a yes in India. Okay, so when you're interacting with somebody in India, don't just go by their body language. Ask them to verbally confirm what they're saying, because they're saying, you think they're saying no, and they're actually saying yes. And like in Japan, a yes doesn't always mean yes even when they say yes. Yes might just mean I heard you, or yes might mean I'm so overwhelmed by what you are saying, sir, that I want you to stop. Okay. which happened to one of my clients from Texas, and I had to explain to them after the meeting that the yes was not a positive response in any way whatsoever. Indians are confused when talking to other Indians. Okay, and the picture on the top right illustrates this. So, you know, if I were to meet you here, I would want to shake your hand. Right? This is the normal gesture in the West. In India, often the gesture is you say namaste, right? Namaste. And that's very common. You see that picture, two Indians greeting each other. One is putting out their hand and the other is saying namaste. Okay, so don't feel disheartened. Indians are confused among themselves as well.